Natural disasters across multiple states might soon have an impact on our supermarket shelves. The Prime Minister was today given a first-hand look at the devastation, the recovery likely to take years.
It's destruction on a scale best seen from the sky and disaster best solved with boots on the ground, in uniform and in a new control centre, tonight, armed with new funding.
I have had to sign off authorisation in Queensland, Western Australia and Victoria will be coming as well, but my government is determined to not leave people behind.
The federal government committing an extra $20 million for clean-up, plus grants to businesses and producers, with more to come in Victoria. The budget allocates $230 million for disaster recovery payments, but the total cost of natural disasters estimated at well over $5 billion last financial year. Tonight, disasters stretch from the Kimberley, North Queensland, the Gold Coast, and now central Victoria.
Our primary focus is on the human cost of these natural disasters, but of course there'll be an economic cost and a budget cost as well.
And that cost could stretch to supermarkets right across the country. Queensland is responsible for a third of Australia's fruit crops, with vegetables also impacted.
You're not talking about recovery being months, you're talking about recovery being years.
Tenny Milligan's Lockyer Valley community has rebuilt after the floods in 2011 and 2022. Tonight, communities like hers, responsible for feeding Australia, face tough choices.
Do we have another crack for the next season, or do we just sell? It's pretty soul destroying.
The short-term impacts of these floods and storms are still being evaluated, but long-term, more disasters will mean more money being spent by the federal government and by the grocery buyers of Australia.
Unfortunately, there's a lot of experience with dealing with natural disasters, but we'll continue to examine things on the basis of need.
The Prime Minister will tour flood-impacted areas of Victoria tomorrow. Charles Croucher, Nine News.